You are in the meeting now.
So I think it's probably important to clarify a few things on the record. First of all, adequate cause is the gatekeeper, nothing more, nothing less. The judicial officer at the Times takes a look at the petition, hears the arguments with regard to adequate cause, makes a decision. That decision could be based upon any number of things within any given petition. A order in limine is an evidentiary ruling, which is quite different from that. So even though something may be considered at the time of adequate cause, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be considered by the court in the form of evidence based upon the court's rulings. And in this case, we do have a court's decision with regard to a motion in limine. However, it is fluid. What the court's focus always is, has this been litigated before, and has a decision been made about it? A bright line is 2017 in this case, and Ms. Voss has time and again successfully argued, well, to make sense of the actions of the parents, now we have to look at some evidence back then. And the court has ruled in that regard. Just because a matter did not survive adequate cause, and is included in a new petition, doesn't really apply one way or the other, because the court's still going to focus on its current order in limine. Okay, and so hopefully that clarifies things. These are difficult concepts, and no question about it. Modifications are very difficult cases because it's not just this case. Virtually every case I've done on a modification has reached back prior, or attempted to reach back prior to the last order that was entered. So that's normal. All that being said, the most recent decision that I made on evidentiary with Ms. Voss is I've given her some latitude, because I'm sensing is that Ms. Voss is attempting to lay a foundation to ask other questions. So because of that is why I've granted this latitude, albeit I am concerned that we're reaching back. But I'm going to allow the foundation to be developed, and I think Ms. Voss understands what the court's concerns are. So Ms. Voss, you may continue.
Thank you, Your Honor. And as a reminder, this line of questioning was based on conflict that endangers or damages the psychological development of the children. And we're still under the heading of litigation. And so, as I understand Court Rule 11, any denials of factual contentions are warranted on the evidence is one of the founding principles that I'm attempting to demonstrate here, and just trying to understand Mr. Knight's position on things that were not disclosed in discovery first as foundation. And so my next question relates again to Exhibit 378. And then I'll go on to 377. And I don't know if you need those in front of you or not, but I've got the citations here. Bless you. Would you like to have the exhibits?
If you're going to be asking questions about exhibits, he needs to have these.
Okay, thank you. Can I have 377 again, please?
Thank you.
And so back to 378. On page page 4. In the first through the third paragraph, you indicate Ms. Voss has decided with no medical evidence to support her belief that Flovent has caused problems with Hayden in the past. The harm referred to by Ms. Voss is harm that is in her mind and is not documented in any medical records. The reason doctors are unaware, etc. Is this still your position?
Yes, it is.
And in Exhibit 377, on page 2.
Yes.
The first paragraph, you indicate that Hayden has never had a life-threatening reaction while in my care. Is that your position?
So I wrote.
That's yes. Still your position?
It's still my position, yes.
I'm sorry, which page was that?
That was on page 1, the first paragraph.
We're on 377?
Correct. And
was that page
that
2?
Was the 377 and 378 were marked
incorrectly. Right, I got him in there now in the correct order. So I'm looking at 377, and you said the first paragraph, first page?
Second page.
Okay, that's where I messed up. Okay. Okay, you may continue.
Thank you. And you've testified about that in the past, haven't you?
Oh, yeah.
And is it your contention still from page 2 on the second paragraph? Went to Epi in 2015 while at school in Olympia. Ms. Voss alleged that Hayden was having an allergic reaction. Epinephrine was appropriate. CPS was already involved at this time due to the previous report of over-medicalization that I had made. Is this still your contention that...
That's what happened, yes.
That my use of an EpiPen at that time was...
Was
abusive.
Inappropriate, yes. At that time it was.
Okay. And so... On page 3 in the first paragraph, it says, or do you still contend that she, it meaning myself, is constantly anxious regarding his health and that high level of anxiety has transferred to Hayden?
Oh, yes, most definitely.
And do you still contend from page 3 to 4 in the fourth paragraph? That's regarding soy products. Dr. Abdullah wants to wait. I completely agree. We will not be trialing soy at this time.
At that time, yeah. And we yet to even try out soy yet. We have not even got there.
And so you still intend to trial soy?
Oh, I do, as soon as we get him past the, his EOS outbreak right now. As soon as we figure out what that is. And when say outbreak, he would flare up.
Out of remission?
Out of remission, yes. That would be more accurate.
Okay, so going back to a previous question from a different exhibit, you indicated that you were involved in forming 504 plans for each of the children, and that you attend conferences and you keep in contact with the school. So I'd like to ask additional questions about that. In the interrogatories, which are exhibit 369. Can we get that, please? I think we're done with those for now.
Are you done with these?
Yes. So I'm looking to question 48. So in the question, I asked you, question number 48 on page 13, I asked you to provide all documentation of your communications with the children's school, including emails, copies of all records provided to any and all staff. At 48, you indicate I have provided evidence of this in my 904s that you have a copy of. You will also find evidence in the thumb drive provided with the 21 question I am now answering now. And so where can we find that evidence?
In your thumb drive and in my stuff here. It's up to you to find it.
Can you please point to your stuff there?
Yeah, it's right here. The whole thing. I got two boxes up here. It's all right here. You had a chance to go over it.
So no, you cannot direct us to that?
It's right there.
Can you find that communication within your...
No,
visits?
I'm not going to do that for you.
And so... You indicate the question at 35. Regarding the children's education. I ask you to explain in detail each instance when the children did not attend school in person. The special needs in the 504 plan.
Are you still on 35?
No, I'm sorry. I'm trying to find the right question.
Okay.
Act 34 asks you to provide a detailed description of your involvement in the children's school. Since the current parenting plan, without limitation, the dates, place, and occasion of each instance of direct assistance with schoolwork, delegated assistance with schoolwork, each meeting, each educational decision, identify and attach copies of all communications by you to school staff during said period. And your response at 34 did you attach any documentation as requested about 504 plans?
Ms. Fox, this is your trial. If you want evidence against me, you have to get it yourself. I will not provide you with evidence that you can beat me over the head with. That's just not what I'm doing. I'm simply here to make the best interest for the best interest of my children.
And so that would be no, you did not provide the 504 plans?
No, because you have a copy of everything from the school, because I made sure that the school CCs you on absolutely every communication I had
objection,
with them.
Objection, narrative.
That is narrative. The answer is no. You can move on.
And so I have in my exhibits, actually, can you describe the 504 plan that has been discussed regarding Rice?
Yes, we have discussed a 504 plan concerning Rice with the team at the school and with the WISE team in place. It is covering the concerns that the whole team has had that also represents your concerns that were brought forth through the representative of the WISE team.
Can you describe the accommodations?
Do you have something to...
Can you describe
Can you refresh my memory?
Okay, so the... I guess that... I'll characterize that answer. I was interjecting myself a little bit early on that one. Sounds like the answer, Mr. Knight, is no without reviewing the plan. Is that what you're saying?
Without reviewing it, I need to have my memory refreshed. I do not have a photographic memory.
And as I recall, I testified, and Mr. Click both testified that we haven't seen it. And so you didn't provide one because there isn't one, isn't that correct?
No, that's not correct.
Do you recall Mr. Moore testifying something about a break box for Rice?
Yes.
And can you describe that a little bit further for us?
Oh, it's part of the accommodations of 504. It's a break box that when she gets frustrated or chooses not to do her work or whatever, they allow her to go to a little box and play with some toys to relieve her stress and anxiety.
It's available to her at any time?
It's available to her. We'll have to refresh my memory with the 504 of how the school was actually wanting to implement that for the benefit of Chloe or Rice, whatever.
And so you haven't provided a 504 plan. I haven't seen a 504 plan. And we only have your memory to go on. As I recall, Mr. Moore indicated it was only available at certain times of the day. Is that something?
You'll have to check his testimony.
So you don't recall exactly from the team meetings that you've had?
If you got a document you would like me to testify on, I would like to see it so I could refresh my memory.
The answer is do you recall it or don't you recall it? And if you...
No, I don't recall.
I'd like to request exhibit 354 and 355. In exhibit 355, I believe it's towards the end. Page 131 of 149.
131?
Correct. It should be a page titled Severe Allergy to Beef, Fish, Mild Products with a photo of Hayden.
I'm going to have to object because the numbering on this is just all messed up.
The second to the last page of the exhibit is...
No, it's like the fourth one. But her numbers go from page 50-something, 58 to 129, and then going on, there's a bunch missing out of here. What's going on?
Well, this has already been edited, so we're going to go into second to the last page, I believe, is 131.
It's different in this. It's five pages from the end on this one.
Oh, okay. Well, it may just be a different. I'm just looking at a bench copy. That's the one that. You're on 131 and 149?
Yes, I am on 131 and 149.
Okay.
You testified previously that you reviewed the health plans and signed them?
Yes.
So you reviewed this for accuracy?
Yes.
And the heading, severe allergy to beef, fish, mild products, nuts, pork, emergency care plan, Does it say anywhere on here that Hayden's allergic to milk?
No, but we went back to the doctor and got
objection.
It re-updated
it was a yes or no.
With the proper one.
It was a yes or no.
And so, Mr. Knight, you'll have an opportunity during your self-cross to explain things. So the question was, does it say anything about milk? What's the answer?
It was a mistake at the time that was corrected.
The answer is no, it doesn't say.
The mistake was corrected.
Objection, non-responsive. Under emergency contacts, why aren't I listed?
Again, it was corrected.
Am I to interpret that as it was an oversight? It was intentional? The question was, why is my name not there?
Relevance.
Okay, if there's an objection for relevance, what's the relevance?
Can he object to relevance every time he doesn't want to answer a question? That seems to be the pattern for
you. He always has the ability to object to relevance. You have the ability to respond to it. The court will make its decision.
I'm going to just note the objection to the needless delay of these proceedings through these continued objections. And the relevance is... We were talking about parental conflict that endangers or damages the psychological development of the children. And the petition alleges that Mr. Knight has failed to provide accurate information to the children's providers. This record reflects the emergency plans for school that are necessary for Hayden's health, safety, and emotional well-being, and to not have mom called in the event of an emergency is something that affects his sense of feeling safe at school.
Okay, it's relevant. So, overruled. I think the question was, why was it not there? Was it a matter of oversight or intentional?
It was not there because I had given the permission to the school district to fill out the proper paperwork for Hayden and Chloe to be in school, because Miss Voss is continuously interfering with what I am trying to do with my paperwork to make it look like I'm doing something bad. The school nurse wrote it
Objection.
Down wrong. You asked for an explanation. I'm giving it to you. The school nurse ran it out.
Hold up, Mr. Knight. What's the objection?
I was hoping that he would eventually get to an answer, and it sounds like we're finally getting to school
okay,
nurse's fault.
I don't need comments. I just need to hear what the objection is.
The objection was that he was being argumentative and not answering.
I think
directly.
He was answering. Mr. Knight, continue.
Okay. So the school nurse made a mistake here because Ms. Voss
okay.
has continuously interfered.
Thank you.
Judge, I have an objection here. If Ms. Voss is going to make allegations, she needs to let me at least finish my explanations. It is apparent here that Ms. Voss don't want me to have any kind of defense here with her CR-37s, with her mixing all of this stuff up. I have rights to object as much as I want to, and if that's affecting Ms. Voss's case, that's on Ms. Voss. I would appreciate it if she would actually accept her responsibilities here and give me my rights.
I ruled on your ability to continue to object, Mr. Knight. And the question was, why was it not there? Which is a really open-ended question, and you do have the ability to completely answer it. And so, have you completely answered it?
No,
question?
I have not completely answered
you
it, because Ms. Voss continues to object to what I'm saying.
Why it's not there? Go ahead.
Ms. Voss continuously interferes with the school and every aspect of providers. I have given the school permission
objection.
To talk directly to the school to
Hold
the
on.
Doctors.
What What's the objection?
He's going well beyond the question here with an entire narrative of that he...
Of why it's not there. And so it is a narrative. You asked a very open-ended question, and he is given a narrative, but it's appropriate to allow him to give the narrative because it was a rather open-ended, and you asked why it's not there, and he's trying to explain why it's not there. So, Mr. Knight, continue.
Okay. So with me giving the permission to the school district to get this from the doctor so that the school wouldn't have to be interfered with Ms. Voss and I's conflict, the school nurse did not fill it out correctly. However, Ms. Voss did indicate to the school that it was filled out incorrectly. The school caught a hold of me, and I corrected it, and I made sure that they know that Ms. Voss is to be on all communications with the school concerning me and the children, and she is the emergency contact. It is not in any manner of me trying to keep Ms. Voss from getting any kind of information or trying to do anything bad. I am simply trying to solve the issue.
You've testified that you're concerned about the children's grades. And
yes.
What have you done to help them correct their grades or improve their grades?
I tell them to do their homework as much as I can. And then I go and I combat with you in court to try to settle our conflict so my children can have a calm place to study. Only I'm not being successful with getting you to stop.
Have you hired tutors?
No, I got the WISE team with therapists because they're more important right at the moment to try to settle my children's minds down because of this conflict.
And so we've established that Rice has been failing since fourth grade?
Yes, she has been failing for quite some time because Mom says that she has a mental illness and has caused some serious problems with her self-confidence.
Was there litigation going on in fourth grade?
I see it. Ms. Voss has not settled litigation since 2009 when it started. I have not seen a settle at all. So yeah, I'm going to have to say, yeah, it was gone.
And so when you indicate that litigation was going on, you don't mean literally any activity in court?
I mean that your rhetoric being spoke to my children about court continuously was affecting their minds, and it was coming back through their children to me because of your saying how you were going to take me to court and take the children away. When they come and tell me, Mom's going to do
objection,
this.
Objection, narrative.
It is narrative, but you asked an open-ended question again, and he's allowed to that.
Okay.
So Ms. Watts, allow him to answer the questions. Mr. Knight, please. Can continue.
So whenever the children come home and tell me, well, Mom's going to get full custody as soon as she gets the paperwork, that is an issue. We need to settle this court stuff so that your mind is not on court and more on taking care of our children. My mind needs to be more on taking care of our children and not on court.
Do you have any evidence to support any of this?
It's sitting in front of you. There's boxes of it everywhere here. I got five more boxes at home if you'd like me to bring them in.
Can you point to any specific evidence?
Right there. What you're doing right now, this 9 days of trial, this should have only lasted maybe 4 days at the most. You're going, beating around the bush. It's you. You're my evidence.
In exhibit 355, it's about the third page in, fourth page in, is what's indicated as page 23 of 149. A wanted sheet.
Objection, relevance.
Well, let's hear the question first. It's in evidence because this exhibit was admitted. Mm-hmm. So go ahead and ask the question.
Why did you not allow this flyer to be distributed amongst students?
Seems to me that would be a violation of HIPAA regulations for my son. And it would put him on a target list for the mean little brats in school to attack him. Why would I want to put him a target on my son?
Does it indicate anywhere on there who the student is?
This is in conjunction with you always wanting
objection.
The child to be identified.
Let's pause. The question was different than that, so I know what the objection is, non-responsive. Mr. Knight has answered the question.
Can you repeat the question?
Does it say anywhere on here who the student
is? No, it does not.
And so, how is that a HIPAA violation?
Well, just random children aren't going to say, oh, there's somebody who wants a lunch buddy, I'll sign up for it. You're going to have to identify the child at some point, which is a violation of HIPAA. And it's in the school can't violate that. And Hayden has the right to his privacy. Just because mom wants everybody to know it does not mean that he has to let it be known.
And so, in the first page, first and second page of this exhibit, actually on the second page, so this first and second page are the 504 accommodations from August 23rd, 2017, correct?
Correct.
And so, this was 2 days after our current parenting plan was signed?
Correct.
And on the second page, the looks like the fifth point down. Can you read that?
Which one?
Oh, I'm sorry, fourth point down in the cafeteria. Hayden, I'm sorry, I'll read it. In the cafeteria, Hayden will have a pre-cleaned liquid milk-free buffer zone, and a designated garbage can for his use only. Hayden will be given the opportunity to choose seating assignments with his peers during lunch. Wasn't this lunch buddy flyer provided in conjunction with the accommodations so that he would not see them?
You know, I'm not sure that wanted picture wasn't posted. I'm not exactly sure because I didn't go to the school to look and stuff. But as far as I know, it wasn't posted. But, yeah, he has this opportunity. And the reason why the thing was HIPAA. There's rule. People have rights, Angie, and you can't just go and put your will on
objection.
Them and expect it to be.
Hold it.
He's gone well beyond the question.
Just stay. Ask the next question.
And so, why does this indicate a a liquid milk-free buffer zone. Isn't Hayden allergic to all milk products?
Yes, Hayden is allergic to all milk products, but you know, we foreseen that a lunch buddy sitting next to Hayden eating a sandwich with a piece of cheese on it, unless he actually forced it in onto Hayden, which is a crime, then it's no danger to Hayden. However, with liquid milk, there is the opportunity of accidentally spilling and getting it on him. So under a safety feature, yes, Hayden is allergic to all milk products, but an accommodation so that it does not impose too much onto him and restrict his abilities. And he also needs to be able to advocate for himself. He's getting older. And this was written when he was quite young. It's changed dramatically since then. Now a lot of this stuff isn't even in it. So what, I would like to know what your point is.
I believe you answered my question. And were any prior 504 plans indicating that Hayden is only, I'm sorry, let's go to the following page with the training summary that the nurse provided to staff.
Okay.
Indicating that Hayden has anaphylactic reaction with the ingestion of liquid milk.
Mm-hmm.
And so why the differentiation in information provided to staff that Hayden's only allergic to liquid milk? Where did that come from?
Probably from the nurse writing it down that way. I have no idea how they interpret this stuff.
You didn't tell staff, you didn't tell me that, withdraw. And so the previous parenting plan, I'm sorry, the previous 504 plan would predate the parenting plan, since this change occurred 2 days after the parenting plan was issued. Was there any of Hayden's medical team involved in making that decision about Hayden only being allergic to liquid milk?
I don't know what your fixation is of a typo.
Now it's a typo?
The word is only. Hayden is allergic to liquid milk. He's allergic to all milk. If somebody typed this up, I didn't type this, Angie. So you cannot put it on to me. What is going on here is I made a decision that was given from the authority that the court gave me, and you don't like it.
And so the current parenting plan indicates, let's see, can we get Exhibit 313, the current parenting plan, please? Wasn't the authority the court granted you limited?
Can you point to what you're referring to?
Was. It's a general question. Was the authority the court granted you limited in any way?
Well, it states that Mr. Knight has sole medical and educational decision making. I don't see where it said and restricted. Can you point out what you're talking about, please?
Did the court make decisions for the children? In terms of...
That's what the whole parenting plan is, was a decision for the children.
Did the court make specific decisions about the children's medical and educational? Did the court make medical and educational decisions, certain decisions for the children?
Yes, it's okay. Called the final parenting plan. And there's a facts and findings in the case too. And then there was a 4-hour transcript. There was lots
objection
of them.
Asked in, he's already answered.
You question him specifically about what the court made a decision, and you referenced the parenting plan, and he clarified and indicated other documents were involved as well. So,
okay.
I think that was an appropriate answer.
Okay. And so on page 11 through... the court indicated specific decisions it made for the children's medical and educational care. Is that correct?
Refresh my memory.
You've got the document in your hand?
Can you point to it?
I can. And item 14. On pages 11 through 13, the court has made specific decisions about how the medical and educational, specific decisions about the children's medical and educational care. Correct?
Correct. There are stipulations under 14
okay.
in the parenting plan.
Thank you. And so the last item on page 11 regarding the 504 plan notes the 504 plan for Hayden may be modified as necessary and appropriate to meet his needs with input considered from Hayden's medical team. And so is there documentation from Hayden's medical team? I'm sorry, let me back up. Who is Hayden's medical team? What did the court order regarding physicians on page 13?
Under physicians, it says Dr. Naimi and Dr. Abdul shall be maintained as the allergist and the pediatric gastroenterologist so long as they remain in practice and are willing to provide care. Mr. Knight may seek and obtain second opinions where he deems it reasonable to do so. Mr. Knight may change pediatricians. However, once he obtains a new pediatrician, he shall continue to use that pediatrician for the children's care.
And so this would be Hayden's medical team then, Dr. Naimi, Dr. Abdullah, and Dr. the physician, pediatrician at the time was... Dr. Lindman, correct?
No. No, the team for the 504 is through the school. This is the doctors give their recommendations, and the team for the 504 at the school implements them to what the doctor's recommendations are.
So you're saying the school 504 team is Hayden's medical team?
We're talking 504, aren't we?
And it says the 504 plan for Hayden may be modified as necessary and appropriate to meet his needs with input considered from Hayden's medical team.
Okay. And so Dr. Naimi quit. Dr. Abdullah, he's about ready to quit. He testified that he's really done with us. And then the pediatrician is now Mason Clinic, which is, we get to see Therese, which is a nurse practitioner. We've been there. So, yeah, we get the information from them, and I take it to the school, and as a team, we go over it and implement it into the 504 plan where it is beneficial for Hayden.
And so the question was, Hayden's medical team consists of Dr. Naimi, Dr. Abdullah, and at that time of this 504 plan revision, it was Dr. Lindgren, correct?
We had a lot of L's in doctors.
His boss, I'm not tracking really well. At the time of the parenting plan or current?
I'm sorry, at the time that the 504 plan was revised on August 23rd, 2017, 2 days after the parenting plan was signed, who was the medical team?
Yes, that was the medical team at that time. However, Dr. Naimi has since resigned.
Okay, why don't we go ahead to Dr. Naimi's records and Exhibit 63, please. Did Dr. Naimi provide any input?
Objection, Your Honor. These here are under limine. These are from 14.
Well, I see that we have a combination of documents in here that include dates up through, I believe, 2018. So, here's the question.
The question was, did Dr. Naimi provide any input regarding Hayden being only allergic to liquid milk for this modification of the 504 plan?
He indicated that Hayden is allergic to milk products, and he also indicated that liquid milk was the most dangerous, and he did not feel that cheese on a sandwich would be harmful to Hayden unless it was put directly on him.
Is that indicated in any of these records?
Did you go through the records?
I did.
Okay. So why are you asking me a question?
Okay. So question is, do you know whether it's in these records, yes or no?
No, but that's what the doctor and I had discussed. So, just because it ain't in records doesn't mean it's not a fact.
And why should we take your word for it?
Why should we take your word for anything?
The think your statement was, why should we take your word for it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Move on to the next question. That is an inappropriate question. He is sworn under oath, he answers the question, and you're questioning, why should we take your word for it?
Okay. Can I rephrase?
You can ask another question.
Sir, this is the type of stuff that happens to me for years.
Mr. Knight. You can ask the next question. And I'm not limiting your question. You could go on to whatever question you want to. You could go back to something similar to what you're trying to get to through that question. It was just an inappropriate question.
Sorry, I shouldn't be trying to find something in here at this time. Let's go back to school quickly. So you've testified that you don't have a lot of time, or I'm sorry, perhaps it was in your answers to interrogatories, that you don't have a lot of time for hands-on involvement with the children's education in terms of schoolwork. Is that correct?
I never put it that way. Why are you putting words in my mouth?
Okay. You can't answer questions. You can't ask questions. You can answer it. So first part, correct. Second part, not. Appropriate, not appropriate. So.
I'm sorry. The question was inappropriate?
No. The answer was.
Okay.
The second part of the answer. First part was good.
I was paraphrasing. How would you characterize your hands-on involvement in the children's schoolwork?
Limited due to prior engagements because mom continuously making me do court paperwork.
And you indicated in your answers to interrogatories that you attend conferences?
Yes.
So, do you know who the children's teachers are?
I haven't met the children's teachers, yes.
Who's Hayden's advisor?
I do not have a very good grasp of keeping people's names straight. I just talk to people. I see hundreds of people each day, and I don't try to remember names, so I can't tell you their name.
Do you know who Rice's advisor is?
Again.
That would be no.
Right at the moment, I have been, this year, have been
objection.
In this trial because of you.
Okay,
so I cannot find stuff out about other things because I'm concentrating on you.
The answer is he doesn't recall. Move on to the next question.
Thank you. Do you know what classes Hayden has been nominated for advanced placement in next year?
Well, considering that your parental alienation has got the children, or they don't speak to me very much.
Mr. Knight, just answer the question without going on to...
Sir, I am here in response to Ms. Voss's trial, and I am trying to answer this stuff.
I understand that you are frustrated, and I understand that your answers are based upon that frustration. However,
yes.
The answer did not ask for that type of response.
I understand that, sir. I'm just
okay,
to the
so
point now that I'm done with this entire process. I am finished.
I can't tell you how to proceed, sir, but I can tell you that you need to answer the questions. And the question was what classes that he is up for.
Hayden is highly advanced in mathematics. He likes science. He is a gifted child, and he could do very well as long as he could have a stable place.
Objection. Is non-responsive. Which classes is he has he been nominated for advanced placement?
Science and math.
Thank you. Do you know which classes Rice has been nominated for advanced placement in high school?
Ms. Voss, when was this information put forward?
At conferences this spring.
This spring? Well, I was in tied up in court preparation, so I did not attend the last one.
Okay. So you did not attend this previous conference?
This very last conference, I was not able to attend. Yes.
And did you attend fall conferences?
Yes, I did.
And were you made aware that Hayden was failing algebra in November?
Yes, I did.
And what did you do to rectify that?
Well, he did not bother informing me that his that he was having technical difficulties with his equipment at school. So it appeared that he just, from what his teacher told me, that he was just sitting in the back of the room doing nothing. So I had him taken off of the high cap class and put directly into class so that the teacher could monitor him and help him better, rather than having Hayden sit at the back of the class doing nothing.
So are you saying he's no longer in the advanced algebra class?
No, he's not. He's actually in regular math in school, not online no more, because of issues that came up about his Chromebook, and he never put it forward that he was just missing some earphones.
And so you're not aware that he's actually learning Russian during math class currently?
Ms. Voss, I've been concentrating on this trial. I have not been able to concentrate on my children. That is my point.
Objection. That was a yes or no.
Okay, we're going to break.
Thank you.
I realize, Ms. Voss, that you are trying to develop details to support your case.
Mm-hmm.
I will continue to allow you latitude to develop those details. However, I want you to consider your questioning in light of a more efficient approach, if possible, as we move forward in this.
Okay. Thank you.
Of course, I